In this problem, we're presented with two current-carrying wires that are perpendicular to the plane of the page. And the one on the left has a current coming out toward us, and the one on the right has a current going in away from us. The currents are different. The one on the left is a little bit weaker than the one on the right. It's 1.3 amps instead of 1.8. And we've labeled a point of interest exactly halfway between these wires. That's at the 2.5 centimeter mark because the wires are separated by 5 centimeters. In part A, we're going to draw both of the magnetic field contributions at the point of interest. So to figure out the magnetic field contribution from the left wire, wire number one, we point our thumb in the direction of the current, and then the fingers of our right hand wrap around in the direction of the magnetic field. This means the field contribution is pointing upward at the point of interest, and we'll call that B1. We apply the right-hand rule again for wire number two on the right. We put our thumb into the page, the direction of the current. The magnetic field wraps around in the direction our fingers curl on our right hand, and that also produces an upward magnetic field contribution at the point of interest. We were told to make sure the relative lengths of these vectors are correct, and because this field is generated by a larger current, the same distance from its wire, that's going to be a larger magnetic field contribution. Now, the total magnetic field at the point of interest is just the vector sum of those two magnetic field vector contributions. And these vectors point in exactly the same direction, so we just add their magnitudes to get the total field at that point. We have to recall the formula for the magnetic field generated by a wire, and that's mu naught I over 2 pi r, where mu naught is called the permeability of free space. That's 4 pi times 10 to the negative 7. With units of Tesla meters per amp, and R is the distance from that current that's generating the magnetic field. So plugging in the numbers for wire number one, and again, the distance from this wire is 2.5 centimeters or 0.025 meters. I can see my units work out. The units of amps cancel there, meters there, Teslas is all that remains. And this gives me 1.04 times 10 to the negative fifth Tesla. We do the same thing for the contribution from the wire on the right. We plug in the numbers, and this gives me 1.44 times 10 to the negative fifth. And again, we're just adding these two vector magnitudes together because they point in exactly the same direction. And we get a total magnetic field magnitude of 2.48 times 10 to the negative fifth Tesla, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.